What's up, guys? I'm going to show you guys how to take this Creative Zen Nomad Xtra into the future. First, we're going to have to pop off the front cover. We do that by pushing the little button on the bottom. It pops up. You're going to take this little case off, and then you're going to remove the battery. Most importantly, probably the old battery. Switch it out. That's a new battery right here. Look at that. Nice, clean. Then we're going to take out the two screws out in the back. It's only two screws. You're going to need a double zero screwdriver. I think it's a Phillips. I don't know what they are. It's a screwdriver. The crosshead one, it has two of them, it's a small one. Just take it off, you pop off the top. There's a hard drive in here, I already took it out. You're just gonna lift it up like that, lift it up out of there. You're gonna need one of these, which is an SD card, a PATA, which you can find on eBay. I found these on Amazon for 15 bucks. Your mileage may vary, some of them don't work. It just takes a SD card to SD and transfers over to this adapter, which converts it over to what the hard drive used to be. And you're just going to pop that in. Then you're going to switch over to the player and then hold down the reset button while holding the play pause button on the side. Take us into the restore function of the player, basically a rescue mode. In this case, we're going to hit format all. And you're going to format the SD card to the proprietary way that this player uses storage. So basically hit format all. Format it should take a few seconds, and then we're going to move on over and we're going to hit reload operating system. We're going to have to load this to a Windows XP machine. I use an iMac, so I use a virtual machine. It worked perfectly fine. Just loaded up a Windows XP Service Pack 3 machine. Remember that noise? Look at that. So we're running a Windows XP in 5K. And we're going to move on over, plug in the USB cord, and then you should get a pop-up if you're running a virtual machine, connect to Windows. In your case, you might be using an old machine. I don't know, but you have to use Windows XP in order to use the reload function. And then after this, you can use it on any Windows machine. It turns into an MTP player, and you can throw in music. So in this case, we're going to use this. We're going to reload the firmware, which is 2.10.03, the latest firmware version that Creative had released. And we just update it. Before this, if you get a player on one something, you're going to format it to, you're going to reload it to this firmware, and then you're going to be able to use it on any Windows machine. Before that, you can't. So then we go to the player and then check it out. It's running. We're back in business. Now we got to do is check to make sure everything went smoothly. Hit the about, and there you go, running on the latest firmware. And you can see it detected the 128 gigabyte. Now we can move on over to Windows 10 and check it out. The player is detected by Windows 10, My Jukebox. It comes up as whatever you name it. Now it's an MTP. You open it up. You see the music folder. And now you grab your fancy little music MP3s and you drag and drop. And there you go. You loaded it in. It uses USB 2.0, so it might be slow for big libraries. But now let's go into the album section. Check it out. Sonic OVA, one of my favorite movies. Let's open it up. Look it. Load it up. We're in the future. Let's go.